together. They can't stop me, even if they stopped me.
What's going on, YouTube? It's your main man, Boys for Life, coming at you with another video. You know, it's hilarious seeing what I'm seeing right now on Twitter, YouTube, just all over social media with the New York Giants, the fan base that has been quiet for the past 5 years because they've been ass. Yeah, see how I'm just kind of throwing up? Me just saying that football giant, you know what I mean? Like, it's fucking ridiculous. You have Cop Pizzle talking out of his ass. You have Tara Belli, who's been missing for the past 4 years, decided to stop talking shit. Was it actually 3 years, I think is what it is. Hasn't done shit on the Giants because they suck. Went off to go do a fucking a gaming channel that had no success. And now he's back, renamed himself, all because the Giants had a good draft, right? According to them, or experts. And now they're starting off 2-0. The only one I got respect for to this whole fan base is Bad Dog. And that's because, guess what? He's not coming back to talk his shit, to be doing what goes on around here. He's staying true to himself. And you gotta respect it. But some of these guys have never left. You have Meet the Mets. You have his sister now involved, Red Z Mac. Now here. And it's just hilarious. It's hilarious now. Tara Belli decided to come out of retire or whatever he was doing because the Giants, he thinks, are now good. They're good? Really? You just got done. You beat week one, a horrible Titans team that you came back and won, right? Then you go out and play Carolina with Baker Mayfield. You put up 19 points, barely win against an atrocious defense. And now you think Monday night, because we're playing the Dallas Cowboys, because we don't have Dak Prescott, we're gonna play at MetLife, where the Giants have been owned by the Cowboys on Monday night numerous times. Excuse me. This is completely hilarious. It shows what kind of fans the New York Giants have. Fairweather fans. Look, Micah Parsons is going to go in Monday night. There's no stage too big for the Lion. All right? There's none. He's going to go in Monday night, and he's going to have 3 sacks. Diggs, and I'm going to say it right now, Diggs is going to finally get a pick against Daniel Jones. What wide receivers do you have? What? Who? All you have to do is stack the box against Saquon Barkley and have Diggs be the shutdown guy that he is and hope, which he will, Anthony Brown has a good game. And you know what? Let Cooper Rush have a balanced attack and let Micah Parsons and that defense eat. We've seen Evan Neal get pushed around in college by Sam Williams. We've seen it happen. So don't be surprised when you see Micah Parsons lined up against Evan Neal. Evan Neal ends up on his ass, and Daniel Jones is on his back 3 times by Micah Parsons. Dallas Cowboys, they're going to win this game. And I can't wait to see it Monday night. But that's all I got for right now. I'm out. Peace.